Here is a short story on how Lord Shiva humbled the Devas, destroyed the Asuras, and also got humbled himself. So Tarakasura, the Asura who was killed by Lord Shiva's son Kartikeya, had three sons, Tarakaksha, Vidyunmali, and Kamalaksha. When Tarakasura died, the Asuras had no home. They had no protection. To save their race and to protect themselves, they went into great tapas on Mount Meru. Lord Brahma appeared in front of them to grant them a boon. They asked for immortality. Brahma refused. So then they asked for them to rule over three cities that would be impenetrable, that would be indestructible. Brahma said, "What is created has to be destroyed." So he cannot give them indestructible cities, but he could give them cities that can only be destroyed by Lord Shiva when the three cities align themselves into a single line, and this would happen only once in 1,000 years. The three of them were very happy because they are great bhaktas of Lord Shiva. They knew that Lord Shiva would never kill them. So they agreed to this boon and thought themselves to be like immortals. Brahma reminded them that if they at all fall into the path of ruin, fall into the path of adharma, then that curse will take effect. They asked the divine architect Vishwakarma to build the three cities. And Vishwakarma built these three cities out of gold, silver, and iron. So beautiful were these cities, and so sattvic was the environment around the three cities that it attracted all the gods. It attracted all the animals. Plants were growing profusely in these cities. Slowly, the power of the Devas started draining away, and the Asuras started becoming stronger. Now, this didn't sit well with the Devas. But Lord Shiva could not do anything because they were very sattvic and they were praying to him every day. Like is the case with all beings, they were greatly influenced by some negative forces. And down the line, they lost their devoutness. The sattvic quality started reducing. Now, when this happened, there was great unrest in all the worlds. The Devas went to Lord Shiva and begged him to protect them. Lord Shiva agreed. The Devas were so happy that they presented him with a chariot that was made of the stuff of time and also the astral aspect of all the Devas. Their power over the animals was supposed to be given to Lord Shiva. This scared the Devas. But Lord Shiva said, "Trust me, just give me the power. Only then will I be able to do this task." All the Devas bowed down and humbly gave over the power of the animals to Lord Shiva. And thus he is called the Pashupati, Lord of Animals. When he alighted the chariot did not move. That time, a divine voice called out and said, "You have not paid homage to Lord Ganesha." Humbled, Lord Shiva bowed down his head and took the blessings of his son, Lord Ganesha. And with that blessing, the chariot moved. The horses of the chariot were the four Vedas. The charioteer was Brahma himself. And the arrow that Lord Shiva was going to use was none other than Vishnu. And the moment the three cities aligned themselves together, he took up his pinaki bow and notched his arrow, who is none other than Lord Vishnu. And he let free this arrow. This tripura of gold, silver, and iron was completely destroyed. This story so clearly and beautifully shows how the Devas were humbled. They had to give their powers up to Lord Shiva. How the Asuras were brought down from their epitome of power, and also on how Lord Shiva humbly took the blessings of his son Lord Ganesha.